Hello dear students and welcome to DAV Mohol Public School. Let's start our today's online session of Standard 9th Mathematics. And today in the Unit 13 Surface Area and Volume, we will see how to find the volume of the cuboid and cone. And we also see the solutions of the exercise 13.5. Now you have already learnt about the volumes of certain figures in the earlier classes. The measure of this occupied space is called the volume. Now if an object is solid, then the space occupied by such an object is measured and is termed as volume of the object. If the object is hollow, then the interior is empty, but it can be filled with air, water or some other liquid so that it will take the shape of its container. The volume of the substance that can fill the interior is called the capacity of the container. In short, the volume of an object is the measure of the space it occupies, and the capacity of an object is the volume of the substance its interior can accommodate. Hence, the unit of the measurement of either of the two is cubic unit. So, if we are talking about the volume of the cuboid, we have to consider the measure of the space occupied by the cuboid. Area and the volume are the measures of the magnitude of the region. So, correctly speaking, we should find out the area of the circular region, volume of the cuboidal region, volume of the spherical region. But we say the find the area of circle, volume of the cuboid, sphere, even though this means only their boundaries. But finding the volume means we are finding out the volume of that particular region. See here, one rectangle shaped cardboard is there. If you will place the same cardboard on each other, it will now we can measure in terms of height. So we say that the area of each rectangle is A. The height up to which the rectangles are stacked is H, and the volume of the cuboid is V. Now we have to find out the relation between V, A and H. Now the area of the plane region occupied by each rectangle, because we are aware the area of rectangle is what? Area of rectangle is length into breadth. So area of each rectangle is equal to length into breadth multiplied by height. So we will write it as measure of the space occupied by the cuboid. So area into height gives you the volume. So what is the volume of the cuboid? Base area into height. And what is the area of rectangle, that is base area? Length into breadth. This formula we have studied in the previous class already. So here we got the formula for volume of a cuboid: length into breadth into height. That is, in simply we will write it as L into B into H. Dear students, don't forget this formula. We can write in another way, that is base area into height, where L, B, H are respectively the length, breadth, height of the cuboid. So after finding out the formula for the volume of the cuboid, here comes the exercise. So matchbox measures, here if it is given in terms of this, means length, breadth and height is given, three dimensions are given. We have to find out the volume of the 12 such boxes. So first we will write length as 4 cm, breadth as 2.5 cm and height as 1.5 cm. Therefore, the volume of one matchbox is equal to L into B into H. Put the values, find the answer. This is the volume of one matchbox. We have to find the volume of 12 matchboxes. So multiply 1 by 12, we will get 180 centimeter cube. Don't forget to write the unit. Now, capacity. A cuboidal water tank is 6 meter long. Long means length. 5 meter wide. Wide means breadth. And deep means height, 4.5 meter deep. How many liters of water can it hold? Remember, dear students, 1 meter cube means 1000 liter. So here, find the volume of the tank and then multiply it by 1000. You will get the capacity or how many liters of water the tank can hold. So in this way, the answer is 135,000 liters of water the tank can hold. Now, a cuboidal vessel is 10 meter long, 8 meter wide. How high must it be made to hold 380 cubic meters of a liquid? So here the volume is given, length is given, breadth is given. You have to find out the height. Use the formula, substitute the values, calculate it. You will get height as 4.75 meter high. In this video, students, you have to find values and the answers of the given questions. Find the cost of digging a cuboidal pit 8 meter long, 6 meter broad and 3 meter deep at the rate of rupees 30 meter per cube. So here again we have to find out first the volume of the pit by using the formula volume equals to L into B into H, and then we have to multiply by the rate to get the total cost of digging a pit. So in this way the final answer is rupees 4320. The same way we have to calculate the fifth one. Here the capacity is given in liters and then length and depth is given. We have to find out breadth. So first we will convert that capacity which is given in liters into meter. Now we are aware the relation 1 meter cube equals to 1000 liters. So first we will find out the volume equals to 50,000 upon 1000, that is 50 meter cube. Now volume is given, length is given, height is given. Substitute the values and find the value of the breadth, that is 50 upon 25, that equals to 2 meter. So in this way, we have to use the given quantities, substitute in the formulas, and then remaining quantity by calculating properly we will calculate. A village having a population of 4000 requires 150 liters of water per head per day. It has a tank measuring 20 meter, 15 meter into 6 meter. For how many days will the water of this tank last? Here clearly the length, breadth and height of the water tank is given and the population of the village is 4000. So water consumed by one person in one day is, calculate the volume, you will get the answer as 150 liter. So water consumed by 4000 persons in one day as 4000 into 150, that gives you, if you will calculate it into meter cube, you have to divide it by 1000. So it gives you 600 meter cube. Now we will find out the capacity of the tank, which is L into B into H. Now how many days does this water last long? For this, what we will do? We have to calculate the volume and divide it by the water consumed in one day by 4000 people. So the required number of days equals to volume of the tank divided by water consumed in one day. Substitute the values, you will get the answer as 3. Therefore the water of this tank will last for 3 days. A godown measures 40 meter into 25 meter into 10 meter. We have to find the maximum number of wooden crates, each measuring 1.5 meter into 1.25 meter, 0.5 meter, that can be stored in the godown. So for this, dear students, first we have to calculate the volume of the godown. Then we will calculate the volume of the one wooden crate. And simply, instead of getting the final answer of these volumes, if you will divide both, you will get some number, get cancel, and the answer is 10,666. So instead of first multiplying and dividing, directly divide to get the answer. So the maximum number of wooden crates that can be stored in the godown is 1,666. Now here a solid cube of 12 centimeter is cut into 8 cubes of equal volume. What will be the side of a new cube? Also find the ratio between their surface areas. Here A is equal to 12 centimeter, that is side of the cube is 12 centimeter. So volume of the cube is side into side into side, that is 1728. Volume of one cube equals to divide it by 8, as total 8 cubes are there. So one cube smaller cube equals to 216 centimeter cube. Let the new cube side be capital A. So capital A is nothing but the cube root of 216, that equals to 6. Hence the side of the new cube equals to 6 centimeter. Now we have to find out the total surface area of both the cubes, smaller one and bigger one, and then we will take its ratio. So after calculating the TSA of both the cubes and taking the ratio, the answer is 4:1. Now here is a question. A river 3 meter deep and 40 meter wide is flowing at the rate of 2 km per hour. How much water will fall into the sea in a minute? So here breadth is given, height is given, and length is given in 2 km. So that we will convert into meter. That is 2 km means 2000 meter, because 1 km means 1000 meter. Now volume of the water flowing through the river is L into B into H. So we have to calculate the volume of the water flowing through the river in 1 minute, means we will divide this volume by 60. To get the answer as 4.
Thank you, dear students. Have a nice day.